بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد السؤال يا شيخنا الفاضل بارك الله فيكم ما هي أهمية التوحيد والسنة في حياة المسلم؟
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد What is the importance of Tawheed in the Sunnah in the life of the Muslim?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه بلا شك أن التوحيد أمره عظيم وفضله عظيم عند الله عز وجل فالله عز وجل يقول إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء فالله عز وجل يغفر الذنوب جميعا لمن أتاه مسلما إن شاء أن يغفرها له كما في الحديث القدسي يا ابن آدم لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني لا تشرك بي شيئا لغفرت لك ولا أبالي ولكن الله عز وجل لا يغفر أن يشرك به شيئا فإنه حتى الرياء وهو من الشرك الأصغر فإن الله عز وجل لا يقبل العمل الذي خلطه الرياء كما في الحديث القدسي أنا أغنى الشركاء عن الشرك من عمل عملا أشرك فيه غيري تركته وشركه.
The Shaykh حفظه الله تعالى, he responded by saying, Without a doubt, the matter of Tawheed is tremendous and his virtue is tremendous with Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah says what translated means, Indeed, Allah does not forgive that partners are associated with him, but he forgives other than that to whom he wills. Therefore, based upon this verse, Allah forgives the sins of all who have disobeyed from the Muslims if He wills to forgive. Just as there comes in the Hadith Al-Qudsi, what means, O child of Adam, if you were to come to me with an earth full of sins, and then you come to me not associating anything with me as a partner, I will come to you with forgiveness equal the amount. However, Allah does not forgive that anything is associated with him as a partner. Even if it is a riya showing off, which is the lesser form of shirk, Allah does not accept an action in which riya is mixed with it. Just as it comes in the Hadith al-Qudsi, what translated means, I am the most independent of having partners associated with me. Therefore, whoever does an action in which he associates with me other than me, I abandon him and his act of shirk.
فالتوحيد منزلته عظيمة والله عز وجل أيضا يقول الذين آمنوا ولم يلبسوا إيمانهم بظلم أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون فمعنى الآية الذين آمنوا بالله عز وجل ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ولم يلبسوا لم يخلطوا ولم يأتوا بشيء من الشرك فالمراد بالظلم هنا كما بيّن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الشرك أولئك لهم الأمن يفهم من هذه الآية أن الذين خلطوا إيمانهم بشرك أنه لا أمن لهم يوم القيامة ولا أمان ولا راحة لهم في الدنيا ولا في الآخرة
Therefore the matter of the Tawheed is tremendous. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, what translated means, Those who believe and do not cover up their faith with wrongdoing. Those are the ones who will have for themselves safety, and those are the ones who are guided. The meaning of this verse is that those who believe in Allah Azza wa Jal as their Lord, Islam as their religion, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as their prophet, and they do not come with anything from the affairs of shirk. This is the intent of the word wrongdoing here as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he clarified that it means shirk. Those are the ones who will have for themselves safety. That which is understood from this verse is that the one who mixes his iman with shirk, then there is no safety for him in the hereafter, nor is there safety or relaxation in the life of this world as well as in the hereafter.
إذ هي وحي من الله عز وجل كالقرآن كما قال الله عز وجل وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى والسنة كما قال البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى هي الإسلام والإسلام هي السنة فالسنة هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم العام. لذلك جاء في الحديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال: تركت فيكم أمرين لن تضلوا ما أن تمسكتم بهما، كتاب الله وسنتي. ولما ذكر في حديث العرباض ابن سارية رضي الله عنهم أجمعين، لما ذكر اختلاف أمته من بعده صلى الله عليه وسلم في قوله: فإنه من يعيش منكم بعدي فسير اختلافا كثيرا، فعليكم بسنتي. فقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم فعليكم بسنتي أي النجاة والمخرج من الفتن يكون بالتمسك بالسنة، ويفهم منها ويفهم من قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم فسير اختلافا كثيرا أن من لم يتمسك بالسنة سيقع في الاختلاف حتما، ولو ادعى أنه على خير وأنه يريد الخير وأنه يريد الإصلاح، فإن هذه الإرادة لا تغنيه إذا لم يتمسك بالسنة.
The Sheikh, حفظه الله تعالى, he went on to say, as far as the prophetic Sunnah, its status is tremendous. It is revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal, like the Quran. As Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, what translated means, and he, meaning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, does not speak from his own desires. Verily, it is revelation that is revealed unto him. Therefore, the Sunnah, as mentioned by Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullahu ta'ala, it is Islam, and Islam is the Sunnah. The Sunnah is the general guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Based upon that, there has come in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he said, I have left among you two things. You will never go astray as long as you hold on to them, the Book of Allah and my Sunnah. And also when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in the hadith, which is on the authority of Al-Irbad bin Sariya, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the differing that will take place amongst the Ummah, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, indeed from amongst you who lives after me will see much differing. Therefore, it is upon you to follow my Sunnah. The statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon you is the following of my Sunnah, meaning the path of salvation and escape from the trials and tribulations is by way of holding fast to the Sunnah. Therefore, that which is understood from the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding seeing a lot of differing after his death, the one who doesn't hold fast to the Sunnah, he definitely will fall into those affairs of differing, even if he claims that he is upon good or wants good and rectification. This intention of wanting good will not suffice him if he is not holding fast to the Sunnah.
والسنة النبوية هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم العام فيما جاء به صلى الله عليه وسلم من أقوال وأفعال واعتقادات هي سبيل النجاة وهي سفينة النجاة بإذن الله، من ركبها فقد نجا ومن تخلف عنها فقد هلك. ونبه إلى قضية مهمة وعظيمة وهي من السنة، وهي أن هذه السنة النبوية لا تفهم إلا بفهم السلف الصالح رضوان الله عليهم، فلا يمكن لنا أن نستغني بالقرآن وبالسنة وحدهما دون فهم السلف رضوان الله عليهم. فإن من السنة ومن السنة المهمة ومن السنة العظيمة التمسك بمنهج السلف الصالح رضوان الله عليهم، ومن فصل فهم السلف رضوان الله عليهم عن السنة فقد فرق السنة ولم يقبلها، وجعل منها ما هو أو أخرج منها أي من السنة ما هو منها وهو أصل عظيم، عن التمسك بما كان عليه السلف رضوان الله عليهم. نعم.
The prophetic Sunnah, which is the general guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, is from that which has come from his statements, his actions, his beliefs. It is the path of salvation. It is the ark of salvation by the permission of Allah. Whoever embarks upon it, he is saved, and whoever strays back from it, then he will be destroyed. Here I want to make a note about something very important regarding the Sunnah. It is that the prophetic Sunnah cannot be understood except with the understanding of the Salafus Salih, رضي الله تعالى عنهم. we will not be able to depend on the Quran and the Sunnah for the practice of Islam by themselves without the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih. Indeed, from the important affairs of the Sunnah and the magnificent affairs of the Sunnah is holding fast to the manhaj of the Salaf al-Salih, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Therefore, whoever separates the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih from the Sunnah has separated the Sunnah and hasn't accepted it in totality. This individual has removed from the Sunnah that which is from it and a magnificent foundation from it, which is holding fast to that which the Salaf were upon, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum.